Hello, I'm Flotter Netfest, and welcome to my Crusader Kings 2 playthrough as the Duchy of Silesia. Last time, we made the High Chieftain of Pruthenia our tributary. And I don't know what this does, but we'll see later on. At the moment, they will give me money. But, so they're paying me some money every month, every year. Not a lot, it seems, from when I looked at it last video. So, I have a pact with him as the tributary, and now there's a war between, that is, Glyndia has declared war against Prussia, but also the king has declared a war against Ruthenia for the Polish claim on Volhynia. So Ruthenia in a revolt as well. They also need to gain half of Cumania. So they're at a war, so Poland is declaring a war for the Duchy of Volhynia. So that looks like good fun. So here's the Duchy of Volhynia. Don't know what claim they have on it. Let's look at the king. Crown Prince Penalty, Crown Prince of Kiev. Seems to have a lot of prince. He has a lot of claims. They're all weak claims. So this is the Grand Principality of Volhynia, I believe, isn't it? So I'm just checking. Yep, he is the Grand Prince of Volhynia. It's hard to say because he's a leader of revolt. So he's leader of the Volhynian revolt, which is confusing. So Grand Prince Roman the Usurper is actually, this is all very confusing. I need to check this guy. This guy is, what do I have to territories though? Gantiev Chernigov. So here is the Grand Prince of Volhynia, Grand Prince of Volhynia. I think it's just the URA thing. What have I done? Do I keep my? Because I was claiming, I'm getting my chancellor to try and claim on the Grand Duchy of Pruthenia, the High Chieftain of Pruthenia, or the County of Marienburg. Or do I move him to somewhere like Skalovia? I might move to Skalovia. Because that's an independent. I can't move him now, but Lithuania is now powerful. It seems to have unified Jadwiga, the High Chieftain of Jadwiga. So he's closing up to become King of Lithuania. I can't declare war of him now, that's why. Because technically I'm allied to him. Can I declare war on the Prussian Revolt? I can declare war on the Prussian Revolt. That's holy war for Pruthenia though, which is, and it's, the war's ended anyway. Also, recently I also gained the county of Cheshin for my liege, and I had to give away Jadwiga to my son, Count Jacek. So my truce with High Chief Mitzas is fading, my tributary war, but also the thing is I caught Chaplin just died. So I've Goshorn, Bishop of Brede, who also wanted to be on the council, and I'm going to him to proselytize Jadwiga because that's still Romulan. Even though my son probably also aimed to use his court chaplain to convert the county, Two heads are better than one, and my count, my court channel isn't doing much anyway. Let's turn it back on. I can make quite a few commanders. More coins. I am already greedy and deceitful, so they can't get any worse. Let's go back to commanders. So, the bishop, he's already got a combat modifier of defense led by his patient attribute. It's good. The bishop. Best to have these, best to have combat modifiers because then they actually affect your army. Like, he may have 11 marshal, but they don't really do as much as this 8 marshal guy. So I'm going to make him. But this is bad, so I don't want him to be. Yeah, and this guy. They also like being commanders, makes them like me more. Still got some vassal levy raised too long from the mayor of Korzhno and the baron of Novi Sach. And some truces are expiring, yeah, I've done that. And I could extort my subjects for money because I'm trying to build a war chest. My chancellor, mayor of Vaclav, kindly suggests that it would be of benefit to the realm if I studied the languages spoken at a foreign court. He also offers himself to aid me in my studies. So he wants me to learn other languages, which learning languages is fine, so I'm going to do it. And that gives me one plus one learning from a student of language. So now, maybe just because I had a big thing last episode where I won my tributary war, I haven't really got much to do this episode. I get four gold a year in tribute, and I don't know what it does. Does that mean I can bring them into my war? Because we are allied, and you can bring in any ally to war. Yes, I can call him into war. He has 1.34k troops. Also, that's 1,300 troops, which he can bring in to help me. And I have 2.27k, and my ally, my son-in-law, has 1.37k. So that's a good 4,000 troops I can use to declare war with anyone. I don't think I better declare a holy war and get his troops because they're the same religion. Never tried it before. But I doubt you can bring in allies who are against your sort of aims. I could try it, but only when I have enough troops myself. But it'd be wise to actually get more troops for myself. Like maybe get enough troops for myself so that I can actually do it without needing his help if I need to. So Pope has died, but it's my child, my daughter, can get a education, and she is conscientious, curious, and timid. So what benefits those? She needs to be a diplomat because that's good for curiousness. She'd also be good at learning and stewardship. Doesn't mind any of the for Marshall or not Marshall the intrigue, but she does mind Marshall. So I might. Learning or diplomacy would be good, because she already has quite good learning. She's quite good stats around the board. Diplomacy would be, because the thing is, I'm not going to be able to play as her, because she's my third, she's third in line to my throne. So what she'd be used for is to marry someone off. So what would I want their stats to, what I want her, them to, she would boost her husband's stats. So I don't really mind what education she gets. I don't really want to do an intrigue, because that means she might be able to try and kill me off when I am my son, because she'll have a claim. Try and minimise intrigue. Diplomacy. Gone for diplomacy. So I'm a the new bird is almost too perfect. I enjoy every hunt with her, and the cook has trouble finding new recipes for rabbit. So now I'm a falconer. I think that an adventure. This is an adventure, and you get Falconer or Poet, and I've picked the Falconer. It basically happens during anyone's war. You can choose between a Falconer or a Poet, and eventually you might become one of them, or even both. It might pop up again. I could try and become Poet. So Poland are winning this war against Ruthenia. That makes our kingdom a bit bigger. Less likely to be hounded by the HRE, and more likely to be able to attack the infidels. I might be able to ask my leader for land, perhaps. No, I think I've done it too recently. Let's try the extort subjects. Do I want the peasants to like me? Nah. Don't really want the opinion analysis for my subjects. I still need them. I still need my vassals to like me better. Because they don't like me. Why don't they really like me? Let's look at my least likely when the Baron on lobbies. Just general stats don't match up. We have 3 traits which he does not like me having. Which means he doesn't like me, which is annoying. I can't change that. And we are now very powerful. The whole Polish, Hungarian and Croatian armies are steamrolling in Ruthenia. Yavyagi is now Catholic. So now my court chaplain has got nothing much to do. So now I can move to my... What can he do? Research cultural tech. Might as well. In my home province. See, my liege, I'm waiting till my liege finishes war, because it'll be see how much land he actually gets. What will he get the Ure Principality? Or will he get the stuff that owned by the Grand Prince? Because it was unclear, based on the claim war. We'll find out soon enough to defeat this 3,000 stack. Skolovia is raiding me, and I was like, oh no, don't. How much troops does Lithuania have? 2.5. So I should be able to deal with him with my troops and Greater Poland's troops. If I were to try and declare war. Don't really want Livonia on him. I do a holy war because I can't deal with Livonia and then Zamegalians and then Koronia. That'd be too much to deal with. Oh, so it is just the stuff that he owns. I'm going to have to unminimize. It is just a single province. The Count of Kujawa has taken over Vladimir Voninsky province, and that's it. So where is Chernigov? Try and find it. Chernigov is still owned by the Count Roman of Chernigov. The extort subjects intrigue decision has popped up again. Don't really want that. So then the Duchy of Kujawa is a single province duchy. A merchant has managed to find out that the coins you minted are counterfeit. Oh no. You are being called a cheapskate since they do not contain the precious metals they were supposed to consist of. And I've lost 200 prestige, but I don't really care because overall from those two events, I've got it twice. I have 200 prestige and I got 200 gold as well, so sucks to be the people. Poland is now fighting the raiders. Yeah, because raiders are attacking, they're attacking my land, but also attacking my liege's land. So they have a good duty to destroy them. If I can get Skolovia, that means I have a nice route to the sea. Hopefully I might be able to get a claim or skill off here. Let's look at the realm tree. I have 30% of the troops and Beshim has 25% of all the troops. Component, my leader has a lot of troops, mainly because there's a lot of personal domain which will fall massively when he dies, because it was split between his child, the King of Croatia, and then the Prince of Poland, because he's the heir to Poland and the Duchy of Lesser Poland. He's heir to the Duchy of Mazovia. He's heir to the County of Gdansk. He's heir to the County of Opole. He's heir to the County of Czech. And he's not here. And by the time I got round to him, they've run out of counties and duchies, because he has two duchies and six counts, seven, five counts. One, two, three. Six counties and two duchies he owns. Yep. So, and then the eldest child gets one of the duchies, the kingdom, one of the duchies, and then the counties inside them. Krakow and gets two counties. I don't know why I might make it easy all this. He has to get more than the next one, gets one duchy and one county. Mazovia and Płock. Yeah, when he gets a pole. And he gets Krakow and Sandomierz. They're the two counties in his duchy that he'll inherit. And here's one of the counties that the other guy, the second son, will inherit. He will inherit an independent county. He'll end up in the. Well, independent from his duchy, from the main duchy, he'll get another one. It's in. Poland is in my duchy. Czechin's in my duchy. That's probably why he gave me Czechin, because it was in my duchy. Oops, I need to go to me. Yeah, desires the county. I desired the county of Opola. Okay, I'm gonna fund the workshop guys again. Hopefully, they won't have business will succeed and it won't fail miserably. Oh, in a Croatian revolt war, that's why we're fighting. Can I? I can declare war for my claim on a pole. Oh my gosh, my council actually votes yes for war. But, I can war for independence. But the thing is, any more I declare on my liege, ultimately brings in both Hungary and Croatia, but I can't deal with a 10,000 Hungarian stack. Your determination and hard work has paid off. Studying with Mayor Rachlav, you have learned several new languages to a decent level of fluency. This has surely increased your prestige at foreign courts. So I'm now multilingual, which means I get extra diplomacy in learning. That's handy. Don't know how the foreign courts would like me of it. Would there be a special plus five opinion from multilingual? I'll just check. My next door neighbour, I might as well check. Clean up Bohemia. Yeah, it just improves my state diplomacy. Or my opinion due to state diplomacy. My state diplomacy is 13. It was 12. Not really much has changed. Don't know how much state diplomacy counts. Might be one opinion for every 4 points of diplomacy. No idea. Do my vassals recognise state diplomacy? No, they don't. Oh, it's a lover for a sake, but that's just love from when I had family. When I had family focus. What lover for a sake? Like, why am I loving myself? That's a bit too Zoroastrian for me. Do I change my focus? It's a bit boring, this business one. I've done the event change before. Because I do want my cities. My city vassals are Baron, as a Baron, I want my feudal lords to like me more. But then my cities will dislike me. Because my business figures, they have plus 20, and therefore they'll fall behind. They will. I don't really want to change, I want to get my war chest first. But I've got enough to get a technology in all culture. Don't really want, do I really, which one do I want? Don't need to have... Let's see what sort of laws I can create. So I can't create tolerance at least 3. Actually, that might be a start. Let's get tolerance law. Let's get the marginal. Okay, he's against it. The mayor of Jabloshkov. I guess his wife won't like him much for now. Let's look at my council, see he might go for it. Why isn't there like... He's pragmatist. So the other pragmatists might not like it. The Istbald will definitely go for it because he's loyal. At least I have no malcontent. I have no malcontent vassals. Two have gone for it, two have gone against. Yeah, Ishbor went for it. My son did not go for it. Has my son got children yet? Yes, excellent. I actually have children. I have grandchildren now. Nunya. Ramiro. And Ajna. Ramiro is a very Basque name. And so is Nunia, and so is Asna. Oh wow, oh yeah, because he's bad, he's given orders to Basque laws. They've rejected the institution of the marginal status of women law. Pigs. Yeah, now my grandchildren have Basque names, that's very awkward. And they are born Basque. Prince Ispor saving from a huge bear. I've grown fond of him. Have you now? Upon the conclusion of a long council meeting, you decide to make a toast. Of course, one toast eventually becomes many and time seems to slip away. Later, as you leave the council chamber, you stumble upon your face. Do you feel the taste of blood in your mouth and dizziness is setting in? I can ask for help, or no, a 30% chance of wounded or 10% chance of dying. I can ask for help. You notice Bishop Ishbor Osvichiam standing next to you. He's my loyal steward. He seems to contemplate helping you, but is not responding to your pleas. Just before you pass out, you see him bring the rest of the councillors out, and they look at you in pity before they help you. So I gained the trait drunkard, and now become bitter rivals. He's not going to be... Oh god. I've lost 2 stewardship. I've lost plenty of combat steward, church and traction opinion. Oh god, well, it was not a good day. Hopefully I still have enough stewardship to keep my domain max limit as 4. But now, my steward hates me. Which makes him, it must make him malcontent eventually. It'll change to malcontent in the future. I love my liege. Yeah, oh, thank God. That must be updated. It's still updated to 4, which is good. We're in another war. The Duke of Baden has done a war to make Queen of Croatia pay tribute. Yeah, that wasn't a wise decision by Baden. Because Poland has been drawn in. So I've got 2. I can get 2,000. We're just waiting for another claim to sort of come up. I still have vicious rumours about me. That's also lucky. That'll expire next couple of months' time. My vassals might start to like me. He's not gonna like me forever. Oh, he's bumped him off. He's almost dead. I'm gonna try and point a successor to him. He's actually quite a good candidate for Thor. Well, he's my best candidate for Cardinals. If I can still get Cardinals, because I think I should be able to, even them. He's only get Fremishnov. He's heir to this bishopric. Bishopric of still miles away because he's not born in Italy. But he's old. Oh my god, your age gets doubled at your points. That's my weird. The opinion of the age is so bad, that's why you get so little points for cardinalship. Why is his cardinal appointment score? His opinion of the Pope? The Pope's opinion of him? I don't know. This is like an adequate place to stop for now. So thank you for watching and stay tuned for the next episode.